I checked bag and carry-on. So for this, I'll just refer you back to your airline. Most international flights will include two checked luggages, and then like carry-ons you'll have to pay for and you'll get a personal item, but refer back to your airline because each airline is different. Another question, is food allowed in the dorms?
在 dorm 可以吃东西吗？
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
Foods
that's it.
are allowed in the dorm, but not allowed to cook.
Okay, thank you.
And then is the sh are the shared areas at the university co-ed?
Jenny? 是男生女生在一起？你。
They will be in the same area but separated rooms. So female will be in specific room and the male will be some specific room. But that is the same area.
What about the shared areas like the
Share area is okay for everybody.
Share area is co-ed. I believe that.
Leslie, I don't understand your question. If you want to add some more context, can you zoom in? That's your question. Let me know if you want to elaborate. Mario wants to know if he can buy Providence University shirts and sweaters on campus.
Yeah,
That
we
say
will
Providence
let them
University. Yeah. There's a bookstore on campus where they can buy.
Yeah,
Awesome.
we will take them to the, because we don't put it online. So when they are here, we'll take them to buy the t-shirts with Providence logo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Leslie, are we still able to plan for our dorm buddies or are they assigned only? If you know that you are go that a friend is going on this trip with you, on the roommate survey at the very bottom, there's a space that says, is there anything else you'd like us to consider? You can make a request. If there's somebody specific that you want to be roomed with, put it in that last field, and I'll do my very best to set you all up according to who you request. Is there anyone to contact if we will not make it back by 10:30?
And I think that the teachers will go with all the students to Taiwan. There will be two. So if you cannot come back to the dormitory, first contact the teachers in the dorm and also contact me or professor or your TAs, and then we will help you. Yeah, we have,
But just
yeah. case, yeah.
We have
But
volunteer.
do your best to respect this curfew, at least on the weeknights. Sophie, on the weekends, if a student wants to go out, is the curfew still 10:30? Or Jenny?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Weekend is still the same.
Okay. I think that was a question by somebody earlier. Do we need to bring school supplies with us? Students bring school supplies like notebooks and paper and pens and paper, or will that be provided? Yes, super simple things that we can provide it, but if you want to use your own and just or you can bring some of them, but not that much. But here we will prepare.
Okay. Andre, the bank, a big bank like Wells Fargo, Bank of America, that's the best place to get a good exchange rate for currency. Typically, you have to have an account, a checking account, at that bank, though, in order to do the currency exchange. So I would just recommend you do a little bit of research on that front. Of course, you can always exchange, like typically at the airport, they'll have exchange windows where you can exchange, or even ATMs, you can take money out, but I wouldn't rely on that. Bring some money with you. And then if you're going to be paying with a credit card of any kind, I would recommend you apply for a travel credit card where there's no exchange fee, right? There's no foreign fee. If you use like your debit card or any other credit card, you'll get a fee for every single purchase that you make, and you'll also not get a very good exchange rate. But if you apply for a travel card, like maybe Capital One or Chase has a good travel card, those cards don't have an exchange fee, a foreign exchange fee, and they give you a pretty decent exchange rate. So bring some cash and then as a backup, maybe a travel credit card. So I think that answers Emily's question. How much money should we bring? Are there any recommendations from the Providence University folks? How much cash should a student bring?
I
It's
will, it's a hard question because it depends on how much things that you are going to buy, because we provide the three meals. So if you can just plan that the places you are going
I will
to play
think.
or and
Dr. Liu?
I would think a minimum of $500 US dollars. You know, in case you need to buy something your own, in case you want to travel yourself, and I think you should do that. And you can be at any large bank in the USA to do the currency exchange before you leave. Otherwise, you do the currency exchange at the airport.
Thank you.
But no US dollars.
Yeah, no US dollars, guys. You have to have local currency or a travel credit card, but a lot of small businesses probably won't take your credit card, so just have some cash on hand. The electrical plugs are, I think the voltage is less in Taiwan than it is in the US,
It's the
and
same.
they
It's the
it's the
same.
same. Right. So your plug-in devices should be fine plugging right into the wall, and they use the two prongs. So if you have the third, you know, the ones that have the three prong, those won't fit. But most electrical sockets are the two prong. But you can easily do a little bit of research online and figure out which socket or which electrical adapter, if any, that you need. Usually, you won't need an adapter. Other questions, folks? This is a great time to ask them.
I have a comment. So on the way I tend to travel for money because I don't like carrying cash, and they don't tend to give very good exchange rates when you're at airports, is that I would use a travel bank account that I would pull my money out of. And the one I tend to use, I put in the chat, is for the Charles Schwab checking account, which is pretty much I only use for travel. So the $500 that Dr. Liu was recommending, I would just keep my money in that account, and then I can pull out whatever I need. And then if I don't need it, then I can leave it in that account to keep it safe.
That's great. Do I have time to share a little bit information before we leave?
Sure.
Okay. So, I'm just going to piggy bank whatever everybody say. First, I do not recommend use international roaming phone plan. Okay, we all heard that story about this guy went to France, got $143 T-Mobile bill. Okay, so don't. And so what you do is some of your phone plan allowed you to have free tax like T-Mobile. Okay, so you want to check your phone plan, are they allowed you to use the free tax? All right, and you want to avoid use the roaming phone plan. All right, so we talk about that. So there's a way we do is we can buy a SIM card at Taipei International Airport, and once you leave Taipei Airport, so let me show you the picture. Right away, right here. Okay, so when you buy at the airport, once we are foreigner, so once you leave the airport, you cannot buy phone card anymore. Okay, so these are the phone company, they are located here, and usually you wait in line or there's a kiosk you can buy. So 3 weeks about 700 US 700 Taiwanese dollar, about $20. So $20 you get the phone card and which allowed you to have internet. So this is internet for you is you want to get internet. The college has internet, and but when you are in the school bus or you are outside in the park, there's no internet. So if you need to do, you need to you need to have internet access. Unless you do arrangement for your phone company, or otherwise, you can pay. Some phone company allowed you to pay like $20, $30 extra, and allowed you to have the part. But just be aware. But you can do a local phone by by this way. And there's a thing is called Taiwan Lucky Land. If you go see here the Taiwan Lucky Land, let me show you. So it is a lottery drawing, and this is Taiwan Lucky Land. It's before you leave. There's a time here. You come in here, register for these, and if you want, you got $5,000 for Taiwanese dollar you can spend. And the other thing is, if you feel like a Dr. Bremer, it's you don't want to carry cash, but they don't buy they don't use credit card very often. They give you a very higher rent, high rate, service rate. So you could at a local 7-Eleven to buy a cash card. Okay, once you buy that, you load your money in a cash card. You can do that at airport too. So you could use the card. So can I ask Jenny to explain how do you use that? Because some people use that. 我们可以在 Seven 买一张那个 cash card 吗？
可以。
嗯哼。那你姐，
Yeah.
哎呀呀，那个可以用那个，
Yeah.
OK，how much money we can put like so the people like Dr. Bremer, I know I travel with her, she doesn't like cash. Okay, now I agree. All right, so but your credit card will not work too much in Taiwan, because at mom and pop store they don't take credit card at all. They want cash, but you don't want to carry cash. So the best way is once you arrive, hopefully you want that $5,000. They gave you a cash card right there. Okay, hopefully. If not, you wanted to go to 7-Eleven or the place Jenny will take you to buy a cash card over there. Then you load your money right there. Then before you leave, don't load too much. Something like that. You use those cash card. There are some suggestion for you right now. You already saw you have two TA right there. They will be help you the all 3 weeks. So my experience, because I start to take student to Taiwan 2017. So you meet a lot of friends. They gave you a little bit souvenir, this and that they do. And if you don't bring something yourself that time, you find out where can I buy something now, where everything. So you pack in your package, pack something, a small gift, represent our hometown, represent Cerritos, represent Disneyland, something, small thing. You pack that to present to your teacher, Professor Lin and Professor Jenny, the TAs. All right. And you want to use WhatsApp to connect with your family member. And so your family will do WhatsApp, you WhatsApp with them, or you are in line right now and you can ask your family, use line, you can invite them. Another thing is, in the line, we are going to take a picture right now. Okay, so at the airport, you take a picture, everybody take a picture here. But in the line, there's a way to collect all the pictures. And so one person create a picture album, then the other people can add in that. Hopefully, the TA can help our student do that. And in our other trip, when I took student to Taiwan, we usually have student create that, and when we came back, then we pick the best album master and give them a prize for that. All right. So in the picture will be, I'll show you quickly how you do that for Jenny. Can you show us or you know how to do it? Okay. So we'll show let me see if how do I do that? Just a minute quickly, okay? Just a minute. I'll show you. So you'll be able to see that's our group, right? And if you be able to see here, you will see Auburn here. And right here, you put a name here. See, I show you one already, then you create bunch. And other people can add in. Okay? So this way you can collect everything. And when you come back, we can connect to each other and after trip after trip usually TACO, Taiwan Embassy will invite us to have a reunion, something like that, and we can show the picture. So that's my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Liu.
No problem. Okay, so I'm going